I'm Lisa Moore. I am the art coordinator at Carl Sandburg College, and this is our annual juried student art show. This year our juror was Brian Baugh from Monmouth College. He came over and took his time and took a look around and made some hard decisions, and it looks like he's done pretty well. There's some beautiful pieces that he's chosen. We have work in all sorts of media, ceramic obviously, drawing, painting, photography, and we've got this show together. We put it up about 2 weeks ago, and it'll be up through, I believe, May 1st. Anyone that still wants to see it will have more than an ample opportunity to do so. There are a lot of pieces that stand out to me, and obviously the ones that won, I don't really feel like I need to address those.
I'm Brian Baugh, and I teach painting and drawing classes at Monmouth College. I started out in community college myself, and so I'm very aware of, the age level and where people are coming from on art like this, and I think it's a really great show. One of the things I'm going to talk about later to the students is just that it seems like they're getting a really good, top-notch education. I walked around and looked at the facilities, really good classrooms. The community college I went to a long time ago had like one room and one teacher, and they're getting a really good, diverse education, which I can tell from the work, because sometimes when you have smaller programs, you end up with everyone making the same style of work, but it seems like they're getting a really broad education here, so it's great stuff. Yeah, I would say I probably judged about six. I actually judged one last week, the Lincoln Trail Art Center, which is a big conglomeration of high schools. The hardest part is when you judge a show. I'm also an artist and painter myself, and so I enter shows all the time. And so you know what it feels like when your work doesn't get accepted, right? So I think the hardest part is just sort of taking into consideration and trying to be really thoughtful and look for things that might go, that I might not have noticed at first, because I don't want to always be obvious with it.
My name is Abby Nichols, and this is my last semester at Sandburg. This is my painting. It won Juror's Choice. Actually, I got accepted to Bradley University in Peoria. Within the last year, I've actually done quite a few little experiments with still lifes of fruit and veggies. And just kind of based upon the fact that I'm vegetarian, just thought it was kind of a joke at first, really. Started with avocados and doing like bell peppers, zucchini, little bit of everything, really. So moved on to a little bit of fruit and decided pomegranates were extremely lush, and just the color really gets me. Red is actually pretty much my color, something that I feel like I work pretty well with and something that really just pulls me emotionally.
My name's John Hendrickson, and I'm a sophomore here at Sandburg, and I'm transferring to Bradley. My art's largely about texture, color, form and shape, and I've been an art student here at Sandburg for the last couple years, and I've just had a great opportunity through the art program here to flourish.
My name is Bobby Johnson, and this is Meth. It is an effigy that I did for an art class 3D design, but I planned on doing it long before I ever went into 3D, three-dimensional design. It took me about 3 months to get the courage to do this, and then about 12 hours to put it completely together. I got the idea because my sister and me had just started getting close, and after 20 years, and then she got really bad into meth, and I guess I just wanted to give something that signified how life decaying it can be. The way I did it was at the bottom you can see there's a step stool. It's sturdy and stable, and you really have to kick it to knock it over. It's bolted down, just the same as a human being is. You gotta kick a person down. You can't just not tip them over. And then it goes up to skin and bones, and then it goes up to bones, signifying that, as cliche as it is, the only way out of meth is death. I put the head inside of the television because it's distorted, and it's seeing things from a wrong perspective, getting influences from things it shouldn't be getting influences from, just as though the actual person was. It has that really cheesy fake smile on it because, well, they're pretending to be happy, not really Not really happy at all, actually. Just got that smile all the time, like they don't have a care in the world, with the hypnotic eye that shows that they are completely deranged, for lack of a better term. And then I got the hands coin out of the box. Well, the whole thing is encased in the box because it's stuck. The person is stuck in, they cannot get out, just as with any other addiction. And then the hands clawing out of the box because they know that they want out, but it's not as easy as it looks. I mean, they're bolted down. They're bolted in there. And they're going to need a lot of help to get out. In the back of the box, there is a full hand made out of plaster, pipe, and a bolt. It's not perfect, but it is a full hand. It has the... sort of the cloud around it to signify that the cloud and the picture frame, I should say, to signify that it's not clear, but it is, and it's not perfect. It's not made of the same material. It's not the typical version of what it should be, but it's all there. So it's the quote unquote picture perfect version of what should be. There's unkempt rugs just to show the not so cleanliness at the bottom. It signifies that, I guess, everything's kind of messed up, but there's flowers growing in the back to kind of show that even though there is all this mess, there is still life. There is still room to grow. over here on the side, there is pills spilling out of the faucet. Those pills were my actual depression and anxiety medication, and throughout the course of this 3 months, it took me a lot, but I figured out how to work out my own problems, and so that's kind of my catharsis on the whole thing, that's actually my happiness that I figured out, but at the same time, the happiness is draining, it's spilling out of the entire box, because there's no room left for happiness. When you're in such a mess like this, I've seen it, you can't just get out. I guess after all the time that it took to do it, I am really proud of it. I am. It's sat in my garage for the last year, but I've been looking for a reason to get it out, and I guess this is it.
Hi, my name's Maggie Appel, and this is my second year at Carl Sandburg, and this is also my second year in the art show. This is one of my pieces that I've got. It's called The Chaotic Beauty of Ink. And basically, it's kind of an experiment with ink because I haven't really worked with it much before. But basically, I just kind of used the dropper and just kept doing layers of drops and then just kind of shook my picture to get the ink to go everywhere. But the thing that I really like about it is if you look really close, you can see the nice mix of colors. And then when you step back, you can see like the abstract forms of where I had masking tape. And it also has a really good contrast with the bright colors and then with the white there. So I was really pleased with this piece.
When a person makes art, it's, you know, you sit down, there's a basket of fruit, you draw the basket of fruit. But I mean, how many of you are really like, in the bottom of your soul, fascinated by fruit? Some people are. But a lot of us have other interests. And if you have another interest, I'm like to see you find it. Once you begin to draw what it is or paint what it is that really fascinates you, then you never run out of subject matter, and you never run out of interest, and you never run out of passion. It just keeps flowing out of you.